for almost 60 years, a Catholic nun with the Sisters of Mercy in Kingston, Jamaica, has had an extraordinary place in musical history. Practically all of the most influential ska and reggae artists of our time have named her as their greatest inspiration, and when she died in 2003, they mourned her passing. Now the BBC correspondent and reggae lover Jonathon Charles tells the story of Sister Mary Ignatius Davies, the nun who nurtured reggae.
The right honourable Tony. I don't gonna feature the man here, you know, that's wrong. He said, stand up, turn!
1, 2, 1, 2!
Just stepped through a doorway into a little bit of musical history. Packed into this rehearsal room in South London are some of reggae music's most influential figures. They're practicing for a charity concert, raising money for a school, thousands of miles away in the Caribbean. And it's all in the name of the nun who nurtured reggae.
From boys' school is a school that caters to the unfortunate. It teaches them trades that they can earn a living after they leave here, and some go abroad. I think you met Rico Rodriguez, he's a trombonist.
The young man him grow very quick, him, you know what I mean? Him become very wise very quickly. You understand? A life, tough life, you know, life hard. And out of poverty, bring it wisdom, you understand?
Rico Rodriguez, amongst the most influential trombonists of post-war Jamaican music, is one. So is the man who gave backing brass to Bob Marley's Wailers, Vin Gordon. Then there's the legendary Don Drummond, who practically defined ska music in the late 1950s and was once described as probably the finest trombone player in the world. They're all proud to be Alpha Old Boys, alumni of the Alpha Boys School in a poor suburb of Kingston. All of the music in this program comes courtesy of the prodigies of the woman who helped to run that school, Sister Mary Ignatius Davies. Jamaica's greatest musical export, Bob Marley, can thank the tiny Catholic Alpha School for his legacy. Over the years, it provided most of the brass backing for his hits. I fell in love with Marley's brand of reggae as a teenager in the 1970s. The sounds of the Caribbean, wafting in from Jamaica, seemed unbelievably exciting and exotic to a young boy growing up in the English Midlands. I know now what I didn't know then, that like so many, I owe part of my musical education to this school for wayward boys.
I'm Tony Green. I was at Alpha Boys School at from 1969 to 1973.
What was it like then?
Well, as a young boy, 10 and 11, you know, you was rotten growing up, and you know what I mean? After eventually I get into Alpha, I ran away the first 6 months after that I came back, and Sister Ignatius was the one who said, come on, you gotta get yourself straight up, you're still young and you got a future ahead of you, you know. She was behind everybody. She was the one who said, spend that extra time as a sister and see what you really need and what you like. That's what she used to do to make sure you come out to what you come out to.
And Sister Ignatius, obviously nuns generally, one thinks of them liking religious music, but she loved non-religious music, didn't she?
Yeah, she loved music with her own boys and produce at the time. They just, music is music, you know, and I believe that all music belongs to God. So we will identify it and where we put it and where we want it to be and what we want it to do. But it's really come from where the bottom line come from. She was a famous girl for skiing. You know, she said her favorite musician was Donald Germans, we call Don Germans, and her favorite song was Eastern Standard Time.
This listening to Eastern Standard Time could apparently reduce Sister Ignatius to jelly. When she cajoled the rotten Tony Green into joining the Alpha School Band, she started him on a musical journey, backing artists like Burning Spear and Gregory Isaacs. She believed she was carrying on a long tradition. It wasn't for nothing, after all, that Alpha was known as the nursery school of Jamaica's brass bands. When she died, just a few years ago, she hadn't really received the recognition that many felt she deserved. There was no order of distinction from the Jamaican government, and the media, well, they paid little or no interest in her work.
She was still interested in your interests in terms of what you want to be, what you want to do, what you like. Because if you feel, I think she will feel too. You understand? It'd be like a waste of time for you and both she. You understand? That's why I think she was very special.
From the moment she entered the school in 1939, she began communicating her passion for music. She herself had been taught by nuns and had been impressed by their concern for the poor. It was that which motivated her to join the Sisters of Mercy, teaching at the Alpha School, which had been set up in 1880 to educate some of Jamaica's more troubled children. Chris Salovich is Bob Marley's biographer and one of the great authorities on Jamaican music.
All those musicians who came through Alpha Boys School really do appreciate what was done for them, because life in Jamaica in, you know, the 50s, early 60s was very, very hard indeed, and they know how they could have ended up. Many, many people ended up, you know, 6 feet under the ground, you know, a lot of those musicians could have been in that situation as well.
I went to Alpha in 1956, thereabout. I stayed at Alpha for a period of time.
I'm not sure that mathematics or history were Winston Sparrow Martin's forte at school, but you can't fault his musicianship. He's played with all the greats, from Otis Redding to Bob Marley.
I was a boy from the Trenchtown, Jonestown area, which everyone would say, boy, that's, you know, that's a hard area. But as a youth from Kingston, I used to follow rude boys, that is rude.
You were from the wrong side of the track.
Yes, way, yeah, whatsoever, you know, and then I got a chance and I go to Alpha. And most of my friends in Alpha were the musicians, because I used to go and sit down and watch the musicians. Winston Turner and all these guys, and I said, what, one day I would love to play with those guys.
Winston wasn't always so keen to go to band practice, though. One day, in the midst of torrential rain, he climbed up a tree in the school yard to avoid the last class of the day and bedtime in the dormitory. It was Sister Ignatius who found him there.
And she came on the tree with her umbrella, and she stand there. And she says, what will you do if you stay there and drown, you naughty little sparrow? So I came down, and the boys in the dorm heard that, and they started calling me Sparrow.
So from that moment on, you were Sparrow Martin,
Sparrow Martin,
not Winston Martin.
No, I work only with my checks. If you give me a check, then it's Winston. But for music, which I really love, it's Sparrow Martin.
Eddie Tam-Tam Thornton is another Alpha alumni. He's a legendary trumpeter, playing with Aswad and loads of other bands through the years. When he talks about Sister Ignatius in the Spartan surroundings of the South London rehearsal rooms, it's as though he's recalling an old love affair.
The first time I met Sister Ignatius was 1945. My father just died, so I was kind of down, like, you know. And when I went to Alpha, it's like I miss my father so much bad. And then Sister Ignatius started to look after me. I'm still at Alpha Boys School because I never leave it, you know. You know, she good man, she nice man, she kind.
She really loved music.
Oh yeah, man, yeah. And her favorite tune is one scotch, one bourbon, one beer.